What is going on, guys? Welcome back to more Road to Glory. This is going to be week number 5 of the high school season, and we are finally back at home going up against the Hoffman Estates Bombers in this episode of Road to Glory. And there goes the music. I was confused for a second. It was really quiet. But checking out the recruiting board, we had a pretty good offensive showing in the last game, locking in a scholarship with Arkansas, and we'll be made aware of that after we conclude this game against Hoffman Estates. And they're also 85% done with Notre Dame, so this game should be the game where we acquire our Notre Dame scholarship. And then also looking at defense, we had a great game on defense in the last one, getting 8 tackles, 2 for a loss, and 1 sack. And we have locked in 3 scholarships with 2-star teams, Northern Illinois, Indiana, and Iowa State. We're almost done with Northwestern, and then Notre Dame is at 42%. So we're making some pretty strong headway. A couple more defensive games like we had in the last episode, and we will definitely be on track. And here we go against Hoffman Estates. And here we are already pressuring Hoffman Estates early in the game. 1st and 10, 3:44 left in the first quarter. And I'll drop back the pass here, looking for a receiver that's going to be Win over the middle. And he'll get us inside the 5-yard line. 21-yard reception for him. And we have already started this game off pretty strong on both offense and defense. The reason why we have the ball here on offense starting out the game is, or starting out the video, is because of the 3-and-out that we pulled. But it wasn't worth it. I didn't have any tackles, but we'll drop back the pass here. And look at Osterner in the back of the end zone. And we've already got ourselves a touchdown here early in the game, not even 2 minutes in. And then look at Osterner eating that wonton soup. I'm going to play it back for you guys. Check it out, wonton soup. Woo! Thank you, base guy. Let's go. Let's get this game started on defense here. Quarterback's going to drop back on 1st and 10, hitting his receiver and picking up 19 yards. And they're starting to pick it up on offense a little bit. Here comes Hoffman Estates running the option, going for the quarterback. He's going to pitch the ball. And good thing he did, because that probably would have been a fumble if he didn't. 2nd and 5 upcoming for Hoffman Estates, running the option once again. And this time I'm going for the pitch. He doesn't pitch the ball, but the quarterback does get hit in the backfield for a loss of 1 yard. 3rd and 7 here, and the tight end drops back in coverage. So I'm playing the receiver, and the quarterback just throws the ball out of bounds, avoiding any type of problems. And here they go on 4th and 7, and the quarterback's going to drop back, and the receiver can't hang on to the ball. And that'll be a turnover for Hoffman Estates. And here we go back on offense. 1st and 10, 45 seconds left here in the first quarter. Trying to move the ball down the field, dropping back, going over the top to Saria. And Saria makes a great catch there, 23-yard reception. And we're continuing to move this ball down the field just like we did in the last possession. 2nd and 10 here, 25 seconds left, dropping back, going to run the ball and cutting up the field, picking up not a first down. It's going to be a 10-yard gain to make it 3rd and inches. We pick up the first down later in that possession. And here we go, 1st and 10 to start out the second quarter. Dropping back, looking for a receiver, taking off the run once again. And I'm going to spin, and I'm almost going to run over that defender, but I pick up 18 yards on the play. And look at me getting hype right there, just punching someone in the stomach. I don't know what that was about, but I'm getting hype right now. Inside handoff to Alex Howell. That'll be a 7-yard gain. And here we go in 2nd and 3 after the run by Alex Howell. A little bit of time spin on that one, and we'll drop back to pass. And look at they left Gio Saria open in the flat, and all he's got to do is walk it in. He breaks the pylon. That's a touchdown. And here we go back on defense. A little over 4 minutes here left in the second quarter, and there goes the defensive line getting the quarterback in the backfield. That's going to be a loss of 6 yards, and they managed to get 11 back on a pass play. But here they go running a bubble screen, and that one's not going to work out. Only a gain of 2. And you got to be a little bit better than that on this defense. We swarm to the ball. We're a little too quick for those screen passes. And here we go, 1st and 10. Dropping back the pass. Going to Weisbecker. And Weisbecker breaks the tackle. Look at that block on the right side by Ostrander. And Weisbecker is gone. That's going to be another touchdown there. And that's going to give us 3 touchdowns here in the first half. Normally, we only get 3 at the end of a game. But we're here with a little under 3 minutes left in the second quarter, and we've got 3 touchdowns passing the ball. And check this play out here. I mean, this is ridiculous. I mean, the block by Ostrander is really what set Weisbecker free. But Weisbecker gave a mean stiff arm to that defender right there. He was just off to the races. Then we end up getting a touchdown out of it. And I'm hyped, because we could put up even more touchdowns here in the first half. And here we go. They're running the option. Quarterback's going to get sacked. Oh my goodness, here we go. This defense is just too good for this team right now. Here we go, 2 minutes left here. 3rd and 6 for Hoffman Estates. They're going to drop back, and they try to set up a screen, but the quarterback's going to get sacked again. Loss of 11. And that stop there gives us the ball back here. Second and 11, a little over a minute here. Calling a streak for Weisbecker down the field. And look at that zone coverage blown by Hoffman Estates. And now we have four touchdowns passing in the game. And we could make it five if we manage to get the ball back here on defense. I know I want the ball back. And the defense knows they want to get the ball back. And here we go. I'm laying out the receiver. And that's going to be a gain of seven for Hoffman Estates. They're trying to set up a screen once again. They do get the screen set up that time, but I'm coming in there for the tackle to try to keep this clock from running. And here we go, 34 seconds left, second and 10. And the quarterback's throwing it deep, and that's going to be an interception by McLeod. And he stops the drive there for Hoffman Estates, two turnovers for them. And that'll give us the ball back here, 23 seconds left in the half, no timeout, second and 16. And obviously, I'm going for that fifth touchdown. I know that I can get it. I'm calling streaks for pretty much everyone besides Hussein, who's running an out route, but I don't want to hit him. And that'll bring up a sack and a third and 22. And now we only have 10 seconds left. Third and 22, trying to get that fifth touchdown before the end of the half. And I'm dropping back the pass. And look at this, blown covers down the field. And Saria's left wide open. And that'll be the fifth touchdown of the first half. Look at that, 228 yards passing, five touchdowns. And we get the ball back at the beginning of the half. And this could very well be the drive that gets us six touchdowns in the game. And we're starting it off with a 24-yard reception down the field for Ostrander. Look at us going down the field once again. That's going to be Saria, 14-yard reception. And this drive could not be going any better right now. Dropping back, first and 10. Going to, no. The defender steps in front of that one. And he gets the interception, and I'm frustrated. I could have had a perfect game. I should have calmed down. I was too hyped trying to get that sixth touchdown. And look how angry I am coming in here just trying to blow up every receiver that catches the ball because I'm seriously frustrated right now. And there goes a deep pass on the left side, and Hoffman Estates is trying to move the ball down the field. And here we're going second and 10, 3:21 left in the third quarter. And we're trying to keep Hoffman Estates off the scoreboard, but I get caught cheating inside because normally they don't run out routes from what I've seen when I'm playing man coverage, and I get beat. But here we go on third and inches, and they're running the ball here on their next possession because offensively we stalled, and that'll bring up a fourth and inches. And honestly, that should have been a first down, but I'm not going to argue with it. And here we go. I'm trying to get the running back in the backfield. I hit him, but I don't get the tackle, but that will force the turnover. And here we go in the fourth quarter, 4:44 left in the fourth quarter. Wow, that's a lot to say. And there we go, deep on the left side to the win. And that's going to be a great catch by him, dragging the toes, getting that ball down the field. And 3:11 here, and first and goal, dropping back, running this ball into the end zone for the touchdown, 4-yard rush. And that should pretty much wrap this game up. Fourth quarter, no reason for the offense to be back on the field, or the starting offense for that matter. And that is exactly what happened. Coach pulls us off the field, and we end up winning this game. And check out the play of the game. That's going to be that pass that went to Weisbecker, and obviously that was the play of the game. No question about it. And Weisbecker, I mean, this play was just... I mean, two things have to happen on this play, right? Obviously, Weisbecker was going to have to break that tackle, but the block on the outside on the defender by Ostrander was really what set it up. And we get four tackles and a sack in this game, also going 13 for 21. And obviously, you guys know that we threw five touchdowns in this game. And we wrap it up with a final score of 41-7. And this was a pretty one-sided game. The Bombers got bombed. And check us out here. Obviously, we're going to move up in caliber for quarterback. But I felt like we played well enough to actually move up for safety. But I guess we're going to have to wait for the next game. So we're a 4-star quarterback and a 2-star safety. And check it out here. We finally lock in the scholarship for Arkansas and Notre Dame. And that was well needed. And we also lock in the scholarship for both Arizona and Northwestern. So we pretty much lock in the scholarships outside of safety for Notre Dame for the schools that were initially on my board. And check it out here. Three new scholarship offers school interests: Utah, South Carolina, and Tennessee. And I am not the biggest SEC fan, if you guys watched my series last year. So I'm going to go with the Pac-10 and go with Utah, even though I'm not a big Utah fan either. And like I said in the last episode, Illinois would come back on the board, also with Purdue and Iowa, three Big Ten schools. And I'm going to go with the in-state school, and I'm going to go with Illinois. And that is pretty much going to wrap up this video. You guys can also see for the first time that I had broken the ESPN Top 150 or the ESPN U Top 150 recruiting list, and I am ranked at number 111. And that's pretty big news. We could probably get to number one by the end of the high school playoffs if the team keeps playing the way it's playing. But that is going to wrap up this episode, guys. I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching, and I will see you later.